In fact, so those are the cities that are responsible most for India's COVID count. Now, in Delhi, the LG has authorized DMs and health officials to impose fines on those not following social distancing. Deepak Bisht gets you this report.
देश की राजधानी दिल्ली में जिस तरह से कोरोना वायरस ने तेजी से अपनी पकड़ बनानी शुरू कर दी है, उसके बाद सरकार और जो अधिकारी हैं वो अब पूरी तरह से सख्ती बरतने के मूड में हैं। वो सख्ती होगी सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग और साथ ही मास्क पहनना, और इसके साथ ही कहीं पर अगर आप पब्लिक प्लेस में थूकते हैं तो उस पर भी जुर्माना लगाया जाएगा। ये आदेश अब यहाँ पर इम्प्लीमेंट होने वाले हैं। इस वक्त हम दिल्ली की सबसे बड़ी मंडी गाजीपुर में हैं, और गाजीपुर मंडी में आप देख सकते हैं सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग को लेकर यहाँ पर खासा लोग जो हैं अवेयर नहीं दिखाई देते, यानी सावधानी लोगों के बीच में नहीं। आप देख सकते हैं काफ़ी भीड़ है, क्योंकि सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग होना बहुत ज़रूरी है और इसको लेकर यहाँ पर लोग सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग नहीं अपना रहे हैं। पुलिस का जो सब इंस्पेक्टर का तबका होता है, सब इंस्पेक्टर से लेकर ऊपर के अधिकारी इस पूरे मामले में चालान कर सकते हैं। साथ ही नगर निगम को भी ये अधिकार दिए गए हैं। शुरुआती दौर में 500 रुपये का जुर्माना होगा, लेकिन अगर उसके बाद 1000 रुपये का जुर्माना है और अगर कोई जुर्माना नहीं देता है तो धारा 188 के तहत उसके खिलाफ कड़ी कार्रवाई की जा सकती है।
Now in Mumbai CST station, the authorities are using AI to screen people walking in. Watch this report.
रेलवे ने जब एसी स्पेशल ट्रेन और यात्री ट्रेनों के परिचालन का फैसला किया था, तब सबसे महत्वपूर्ण सवाल यही उठा था कि इतनी बड़ी संख्या में यात्रियों की थर्मल स्क्रीनिंग कैसे होगी और साथ ही साथ सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग का पालन कैसे होगा। लेकिन रेलवे ने वो तमाम कदम उठाए जिससे न सिर्फ थर्मल स्कैनिंग आसानी से हो रही है बल्कि सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग का भी पालन हो रहा है। मैं सीएसटी स्टेशन पर मौजूद हूं। यहां पर आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस बेस्ड कैमरा लगाया गया है थर्मल स्क्रीनिंग के लिए। जब मैं यहां खड़ा हूं, यहां से आप देख रहे हैं मेरे सामने एक कैमरा लगा हुआ है जहां मैं जिसकी नजर में हूं, और ये जो है सीधा मेरे माथे को कनेक्ट करता है और माथे के बाद जो थर्मल स्क्रीनिंग होती है कि आपके शरीर का तापमान कितना है, ये सारी चीजें इससे पता चलती हैं। महत्वपूर्ण चीज ये है कि आपको एक एक करके अंदर जाना है, यानी सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग का भी ख्याल रखना है, और महत्वपूर्ण चीज ये है कि जो थर्मल स्क्रीनिंग है, थर्मल स्क्रीनिंग के दौरान अगर आपका शरीर के तापमान ज्यादा होगा तो तुरंत वो रेड हो जाएगा और तुरंत आपको स्टेशन परिसर से बाहर किया जाएगा।
Now let's take you through the states that are contributing most to India's case count. Now the contribution of just 7 states as indicated on the left side of your screens is 76%. So most of the viral load is coming from these 7 states that are on your screens, and the rest of India is just a mere 24%. Let's focus on Rajasthan. Remember Bharatpur, Dholpur, these districts have also emerged as major hotspots along with the ones that we already know about like Jaipur and Jodhpur. Gujarat has contributes 7% of the total cases. Most of those cases are in Ahmedabad, about 70% of them. Now Maharashtra, if you look at those that percentage, it indicates that one in every three COVID-19 patients in the country is from Maharashtra, which is a huge number. Tamil Nadu has 13%. Remember, Tamil Nadu just crossed the 40,000 mark 2 days ago, and yesterday once again it saw the highest single day spike. Madhya Pradesh at 3%, Uttar Pradesh at 4%, which has been seeing more cases in the urban areas like Lucknow, Kanpur, as well as areas nearing the national capital like Noida. We have Delhi as well at 12%. Delhi continues to remain our focus, and remember, Home Minister Amit Shah is chairing a series of meetings today as well to deal with the crisis in the national capital. Now let's take a look at some other top stories from across the country. Authorities of Daryaganj Vegetable Market at Old Delhi have been stepping up vigil to fight the coronavirus. Even as temperature guns are being used to screen people at entry, social distancing norms are being flouted. Punjab Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh introduced a daily point system under Mission Fateh, wherein all residents can download the Kova app and register daily precautions being followed against coronavirus. Regular users will be recognized by the state government as Mission Fateh warriors. Punjab Chief Minister has also said that it will help them improve testing capacity to 11,000 per day. Norms of social distancing were flouted at a protest organized by Congress MLA Vinay Jaiswal in the district of Chhattisgarh, demanding the reinstatement of 32 workers of a company. Leaders were seen wearing masks and shouting slogans, while at the same time crowding the public space. Farmers in Shimoga are facing hardship due to increase in prices of seeds amidst the lockdown restrictions. Farmers say that one packet of 3.5 kgs of maize seeds costs 1,300. Due to migrant workers returning home, there is also a shortage of labour, which has increased its costing this year. Assam Chief Minister Sarbanand Sonowal and Union Petroleum Minister Dharmendra Pradhan discussed the repercussions of the Baghjan gas leak tragedy in Guwahati in presence of senior ministers and dignitaries. They discussed ways to combat the well fire and provide relief to the affected people. Both the leaders will visit the area today to assess the situation. Assam Health Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma has warned of another lockdown if the situation worsens in Guwahati. State government will be testing 50,000 people in Guwahati at 12 testing camps on the 16th of June after analysing results in 7 days. If a sizeable population is found positive, another lockdown will be imposed in the city. Patanjali CEO Acharya Balakrishna claims that the company has found a cure for COVID-19 and the team has been working on it since the advent of coronavirus. The CEO has said this medicine was able to cure COVID-19 patients in 14 days, and clinical case studies on hundreds of COVID-19 patients yielded 100% favorable results. Well, cutting across once again to the national capital, where the meeting at the Ministry of Home Affairs has just concluded. In fact, you can see officials leaving the Ministry of Home Affairs. The meeting has lasted for about an hour and a half. It began, remember, at 11 a.m. Going across to Arunuma, who is at the spot. Arunuma, it looks like everyone is leaving right now. Any further details you have as to what transpired during this meeting?
So as we are speaking, Dr. Harshvardhan is stepping out. Media reporters are trying to ask him for a sound bite, but he's refusing. He's just getting into his car and leaving there. Ravinder, if you can just show them, Dr. Harshvardhan, the health minister, not answering queries from the media who are repeatedly requesting him from some kind of a soundbite. This was exactly the scene when Chief Minister of Delhi left Arvind Kejriwal and Manish Sisodia and LG left about 2 minutes back. Again, we repeatedly requested them for some kind of indication as to what was decided in the meeting. But I think that is being left to the Ministry of Home Affairs official media cell as well. We are now expecting a press release or a tweet from HMO handle. So we'll request my colleagues up there in the newsroom to watch out for the HMO handle as well as the Chief Minister's handle to see if any tweet is put out. Right now, what we are being told is that none of the participants of this meeting have been given the nod to speak to the press. All of them who have come out, the Chief Minister, the Deputy Chief Minister, the LG, the Health Minister, none of them addressed the media yet. We're still waiting to know as to what really happened inside, what kind of decision has been taken. And we are expecting a press note or a tweet in a while from now, and then we'll be able to tell you more about what was decided.
Right. Are we also expecting an official announcement later this evening, even though, of course, the officials, neither the Chief Minister nor the Health Minister, like you're saying, are willing to speak right now?
See, 5 o'clock, there is a second round of meetings, so there could be a possibility that only at the end of that meeting, consolidated outline will be given to all of us as to what was discussed and what has been decided upon. Today's meeting was attended, the morning meeting, by Dr. Randeep Guleria, the AIIMS director, the CM, the LG, Satendra Garg, the health minister, home minister of the country, health minister of the country. They were all there. Medical infrastructure ramping up, better coordination, more functional helplines, all of these were discussed. In the meeting at 5 o'clock, the same issues at the municipality level will be taken up, and we're still waiting to know what is decided. We have not received any official confirmation so far. I think the Delhi Health Minister, I've not seen him stepping out, so let's just wait and see if he steps out, there will be any kind of briefing given.
Right. Also, Arunuma, Delhi, of course, has a unique model with power being allocated between the center, the lieutenant governor, the MCDs, as well as the Delhi chief minister. We've seen a lot, this resulting in a lot of confusion as well. Kejriwal took that decision on allocating beds only for Delhiites, something that was reversed later by the Delhi lieutenant governor. So, of course, this series of meetings hopefully will ensure that all these parties are on the same page.
Yes, that is one important issue, that there was a lack of coordination. There are various other administrators who administer Delhi. There is chief minister in his cabinet. There is the home minister, who through the LG also administers the national capital. And then there are the three municipalities for each area of Delhi. So the coordination is an issue. I have spoken to multiple patients who have told me that even though helplines have been set up, those helpline numbers either don't work, or whoever picks them up is not helpful at all. As far as the app is concerned, which is supposed to tell patients about bed availability, there is a problem there as well. The app seems to suggest that beds are available, but when patients go to hospitals, they are told they are not. Which are the kind of patients who can be treated at hospitals? On that also, patients are getting confused. Lot of panicky patients running to hospitals only to be told that their symptoms are not critical enough for admission. So these were all issues brought in at the meeting today, we are told. Also, doctors and their grievances, non-payment of dues, not enough safety measures being taken for them, overworked, overstaffed. All of this, we are told, has been discussed, because the big concern is that Delhi numbers are constantly rising, and we have to find a way to ensure the safety of those who are testing positive for COVID.
Right, stay on with us, Arunma. Let's also go across to Rupeshree Nanda, who tracks the Delhi government. Rupeshree, I know it's early, the meeting has just finished, but anything you're being able to gather at all through your sources about what happened?
Well, Vandana, not really, because, it is, like you said, it has just got over and people are just coming out of that meeting. But we expect the Chief Minister and the Health Minister to reach here very soon, and we expect to get some information on the meeting sooner rather than later. Now, remember, it was expected to be a review meeting. So, essentially, the Delhi government was planning to do is place on the table each and every measure that it has taken and will take to combat the COVID-19 crisis in the capital, and perhaps give an impression that things over here in the national capital are not actually out of control, because that is the impression that had been gaining ground over the past few days. And with the kind of information that the Chief Minister has also tweeted since morning, that 5,000 more beds will be available very soon, and the kind of information that we've received from the Lieutenant Governor's office, and the attempt essentially was to convey that the situation is under control. But we will really have to wait for a few more minutes in order to find out exactly what happened in the meeting, whether it was just a stock-taking meeting or were some important decisions also taken in that meeting.
Right, so you're with us, Rupeshree. Let's, bring in Arunma as well. Arunma, like Rupeshree was saying, yet to be ascertained whether it was just a stock-taking meeting or whether there is the likelihood of any drastic decision being taken or announced, like possibly a withdrawal of the relaxations and extension of the lockdown.
I don't see that happening immediately. As far as lockdown is concerned, I'm not expecting any decision to be made in this meeting today. There are a lot of rumors doing the rounds. I'm aware of them. A lot of people are messaging and asking whether the lockdown is coming back to Delhi. We have on record Delhi's health minister saying that for Delhi, that is not being proposed. From the Home Ministry officials also, PIB fact check, in fact, 3 days ago or 4 days ago, did a fact check of a social media post which was going viral, saying lockdown is going to be back from 15 June. So as far as official word is concerned, both from the center and the state, there is indication that right now, as we speak, extension of lockdown or bringing back lockdown is not on the table. Having said that, it is a possibility that at the local level, market associations, for example, are writing saying we're not feeling safe enough. Already footfalls in some markets are low, so there is no reason to risk the life of traders. So there is a possibility that market associations unilaterally could pull down the shutter for a lot of important markets in Delhi. There is a possibility that there could be stricter implementation of restrictions in containment zones in the national capital. But the pan-India lockdown that we were used to in lockdown 1, 2, 3 and 4, Right now, there is no indication that is being considered by the state government or by the central government.
All right, so an extension of the lockdown completely off the table, like Arunuma was saying, but going back across to Rupeshree, that of course will indicate that the focus will be on ramping up medical infrastructure, which we know a number of decisions have already been announced by the Delhi government. Nursing homes are being roped in, private hospitals are being asked to keep a certain percentage of their beds available. The Delhi government has also warned of severe repercussions in case these institutions do not comply with the directive.
Yes, that is a warning that the Delhi government has said, but the Chief Minister has also toned it down by saying that if nursing homes have any issues, then the government is ready to deal with them and handhold them in order to enable them so that they can perform what the government expects of them to do now. Apart from that, remember, even RWAs, resident welfare associations in various housing societies have also been roped in, and those spaces within housing societies like community halls are also being considered essentially to serve as either quarantine centers or give a first primary care to people who test positive. And it is not just keeping patients all over there, but also ensuring there is some trained personnel to take care of this, apart from medical equipment like oxygen concentrators and cylinders. About hotels, banquet halls, other religious places are giving their spaces for makeshift hospitals. It has already been reported upon. And in the coming 1 week, we are going to see massive activity happening on that front. Apart from that, the other really important thing to watch out for is the price cap on private medical practitioners and hospitals, reduction in COVID tests by private labs, and also reduction in the charges of ambulances by private service providers. So these are some of the steps that the government has taken in order to relieve the distress on the ground. And we are just waiting, Vandana, to hear whether it was just a review meeting, whether the Home Minister just took stock, or whether any important decisions were taken at that meeting. But so far, we have not heard from anyone.
All right, stay on with us, Rupeshree, as well as Arunuma. We'll keep tracking the details of that crucial meeting, but right after this quick break, stay tuned.